Hello and welcome, my friends. Today we're going to be a bit of a React Andy. I mean, that's what we do always. And today it's going to be special because we're going to react to Faker's introduction to the Hall of Legends, right? It's been pretty popular so far. Many videos have been released. And yeah, we're going to be a bit of a React Andy and let's see what animations, what concepts, like what does Riot Games have in store for the man, the myth, the legend of our lovely game. And yeah, let's just enjoy some quality League of Legends content together in a bit of a different way than usual. Hope you enjoy. And let's continue. Obviously, everything here is blind. Let me know your first thoughts. Some of these videos have been out for days, weeks, hours, depending on obviously when this video will release. But enough yapping, let's go into it. And honor to Faker, the unkillable demon king. That's the first one. Let's see. Obviously here, Faker with like old equipment. It's like the Leblanc staff, the old better world championship trophy. What's that, Ryze in the background with the scrolls, Galio. Yeah, references to Ryze, the music video, of course. What's that? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, 2017-18, Despair, Twisted Fate hat. Okay, interesting. And I mean, everyone knows, right? The leaks about it being an Ahri skin. I think that's nothing too uncommon. Oh, the penguin. Oh, very nice. I'm not sure if he still has that as his profile picture, but okay, yeah. Overall, pretty nice run, right? Introducing or like hinting at like a journey here. Nice images, maybe could have been a bit much, but could have been a bit more, I guess. But as a first introduction to the concept, pretty nice. Let's go with the next one. Hope I put them in the right order. Okay. Okay, constructed different. Good times. Cathedral. Lovely. Good times, good times. Hey, our enemies. We're going to get them. Oh, man. That was... What the fuck? Yeah, man, nice. No, of course not. How could that be? Like, that question has always been so silly. Like, as much as like other players are great, like, sorry, like there's Faker and then there's the rest. Like, you can't redefine League of Legends like anew. I mean, like, huh? Like, Faker is one of the biggest reasons why League of Legends is as big as it is right now, and how could that happen again? Like, maybe the next like icon comes into the scene, wins worlds in his debut year. It's like miles ahead of everyone. What else can we say? And then makes the game even more popular. I mean, like, maybe puts it up, I don't know, with like football or something like that, and like billions of people watch it. I don't know, but that's all too like way too far-fetched. And again, it would be just something different, right? It would be not another Faker. We have a couple more seconds here. League of Legends ex Faker, right? Obviously he's going to be the CEO of League of Legends first, and then he's going to become the president of Korea. And that's it. So this again, another so a circle jerking here of Faker, obviously pretty cool, I feel, getting like all the different people in, and it's called trailer, so maybe we're on. Let's take a look at the main video here, uploaded by the LCK, right? 10-minute video, I think that's what the trailer is for. Let's just see the place. Okay. What's this? Oh, this is from this year's Worlds, okay. Yeah, pretty nice play here, obviously, at the alley-oop by Crisp, right, with the Bard ult. And then, cut down one. And yeah, this the was it Spring King or something, but it was Autumn, right? So it's not Xiaohu's time, so like he's done though. And here's like, ah, let's just get some more money. We cut away the part where he dies at the end, very lovely, very lovely. Okay, what's this? This is a couple years ago, this is like... Is it 19? No. This is a couple years ago. The Hens is already at KT, so this is like 20, 21 or something. Okay, this is obviously 2015. Oh, actually it says at the bottom, we can't spoil ourselves. Bam! Look away, bam, very nice. I think this is one of the best plays Faker has ever done. Lovely to see it in this one, right? The reaction time on that, especially back then, right? Unbelievable. Ooh, 2014. No. 14? Should be 14, whatever. Not bad, not bad. And he gets the kill back. Oh, man. 20p graphics, crazy times, and this set all stars, I think. Pretty respectable, respectable. Nice that we see some old plays. Do we get his first kill or something? Oh, no, this is from last year, no. This feels recent, but looking at the roster, it's 19, yeah, 19. Yeah, I mean, very just lovely. Then he goes back again and gets the chain, double flashes, W's, and goes back for the auto Q. Just a classic annoying Leblanc, right? A play that personifies Leblanc, just very nice for him. What else do we have? Okay. Oh, this is Faker Shockwave will absolutely decimate the ranks of KT roster moment. Hey. Ah, oh, man. Good times. Ah, oh, KT. Let's go. Oh, 15 worlds or 16? 16. Yeah, ah, the sidestep and the mechanic to flash the what is it? The Rek'Sai ult. Obviously, that's not in the game anymore. And then, yeah, also here, Wolf and Peanut doing some fun stuff. Actually, Peanut, that's 17 then. Ah, well, whatever. And, yeah, obviously this is, which MSI is it? 20, 21, I think? Whatever. Yeah, obviously, Caps again, his ankles were broken, right? Same or similar story happened this year. Yeah, very nice. And then he turns around and looks at the camera. Ah, man, just great. What is it? 14 finals. Ah, yeah. Okay. He misses the Q. Everyone thinks it's over, right? But then Flash, Wind War, and then... Yeah. Kuro kinda got too antsy there and closed the gap, right? Obviously here is, yeah, debut solo kill on the mission, right? I think we got a... Didn't we have like something similar happen this MSI where Canyon's Kha'Zix transformed in the face of the enemy? Anyway, I don't remember this one. Yeah, I don't remember this one. What are we looking at here? He flashes over the wall, hits nothing, and he just ults him to death. Okay, that's just a wild play. Oh, this is the Ahri, impact Ahri carry, right? Like, I mean, Faker is doing so much damage here. He assassinates Prey. Obviously, we have to mention Puma and Du's insane ult at the start of it. But, yeah, very nice. And here, him and impact clean up the fight. Expression, I can't pronounce names, man. It's, whatever, yeah. Very nice to sneak in some Ahri gameplay here, right, obviously. In the highlight of the upcoming, what is it, the upcoming skin. Man, I will buy the shit out of that one. Look at him, man, he's so young. Ah, good times. Actually, we don't need subtitles for this part. And then obviously here, Faker's escape with just the ghost, right? That small little sidestep, Smash flashes forward, gets the slow, but it's just not enough. Faker with perfect lineup for the ult. Would have mattered? Maybe, maybe not. Obviously, this game state is a bit more neutral, but yeah, they could have absolutely forced some shit here, and in the meantime, I think Bang got a turret in mid lane or something like that. So yeah, very nice play. Not game winning, but just really cool. What are we looking at here? Oh, this is JDG gets swooped into the trash can. Look at Faker coming around, swooping up three or four people here, depending on what my eyes can make out. Okay, yeah. What is it? Yeah, this is the backdoor against RNG in the in the first match, actually. Because the second game was also pretty crazy, if I'm remembering that one correctly. Ah, man, look at this. I mean, here this is obviously a bit less flashy, right? It's, we assume it's Faker's call, and yeah, he is the first one to die, but he's the one to set it all up. And yeah, effort with some recoil cancelling and all. Yeah, pretty nice. What else do we have here? Oh, this is, yeah, also very recent. We need the slow replay here for this one. I mean, yeah, they're winning the fight. We get the replay of the start, how he got the 5-man. No, come on, we don't. This is... Look at this. Like, it felt like damage nowadays, it's like probably more and so, whatever, but like the HP, the way HP bars like dipped and disappeared back then, it's just beautiful, man. And obviously here, like, take a shockwave and so on. Amazing play, obviously, by the entire lineup, right? It's like an alley oop, dunk, and I don't know. I mean, I don't know much about basketball to comment more on that, but it's just amazing. Like, such a good team effort. What is this one? This is 18, I think. No, it's also 19. I don't have this as a, like, a banger memory, but yeah, obviously he goes in, gets a kill, deters Baron. Okay, pretty nice. What do we have here? Catches Maps Lulu. Oh yeah, that's isn't this a flash forward? And then all of the spells, boom, 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 boom. Marin tries to get something, but he doesn't get anything. And yeah, I mean, back then Rice was just, wow, very nice. Actually, hey, Marin got an assist. My memory is wrong. I thought Marin didn't get anything there. But hey, I mean, so far, so many great plays. And obviously here we have Cassante, right? A champion with 4,700 HP and all kinds of other issues. And yeah, obviously this is from this year, if I'm not mistaken. I think it's regular split. Not, well, was not from the finals slash playoffs. Anyway, very nice Cassante gaming. What is this? Oh no, oh god. Don't look at Teddy, don't look at Teddy. Oh my god, he flashes away the moment Faker goes for the play. We may have gotten like two more kills that snowballs into Baron, and then could have done so much. I mean, it's an amazing play, right? But that roster was so good, but also so fucked up as a, like, a team. Okay, obviously we're going to have that one. Trouble, death mark. Set up. Look at the clans, look at the moves. Very nice. Ah, oh, man. Absolutely amazing. I mean, you can say whatever the fuck you want. That play is absolutely insane. I mean, people have tried to like replicate it, and obviously mechanics nowadays are like way better. Have fun with your like single digit ping and practice tool and whatnot. But yeah, whatever. Goated play ever. Oh, obviously, yeah, okay. Ending the golden road. Absolute fucking cinema. And I mean, the overall team fight by T1 here is just really great as a whole, right? But Faker obviously sets it up, brings him in an absolute winning position, right? And yeah, with that, it's Jover for the golden road, right? Auto attack first, right? So he like waits for ruler to flash, and then, I mean, he flashes first, but it's like, I don't know, man. He sets it up right for him, and this transition, oh, it's just beautiful. This video so far is absolutely chef's kiss. What's this? Oh, we just fade to black. Hall of Legends. Okay, anything else? Man, this video so far was the best one. I mean, obviously. Okay, and now I think this is the most recent one. Photosensitive warning. Okay. Looks good. Oh, get it. It's Leblanc. Is this Hall of Legends Leblanc? What's she waiting for? Let's turn up the music. Oh, I don't know. What is this? This looks... Why is that? Whatever. I don't like this. Okay. I know that guy. Yeah, I think that is it. Yeah, this is it. Yeah, I don't know, man. I think the design is obviously very weird. We have a better look at it. I mean, here Leblanc, I mean, it's pretty interesting, right? That they choose Ahri for her, for him. We have all these other champions, right? Orianna is going to be his new skin, right? Then we have Syndra. Ryze is not missing, Ryze is kind of missing here in this video. This is Leblanc here also like leaking like this outfit. Interesting, I guess. Do we get Ryze here at some point? Did I miss it? I don't think so. And then here, I don't know, like jumping the gap or whatever. Here's obviously the one and only Azir, right? What's this? Who's the other one there next to him? Azir and... Who's this? Oh, this is just the second Azir. Okay. The staff? No, it's the same, yeah. So yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think the design is very basic, right? You don't... You look at this... And it's like, oh, is this Faker? No, you don't look at this and think, oh, this is a Faker skin, right? This is a T1 skin. You see, this is Ahri. This is like Conqueror. Is it Conqueror? This is like Conqueror Ahri. I think the wolf hat as a tail is absolutely terrible. Fox, obviously. Yeah, I think that's just weird. A tail is a tail. It's not a fucking chimera or whatever where like the tail has a head or something. Yeah, I think the design looks good. Although a bit like basic, good but basic, right? And the wolf head, fox head is, I think it's just not it. Obviously here we have like the golden form for when she ults, right? That's obviously what this is mimicking here. Which again, looks all gorgeous, right? Nice animation and so on. But am I missing something? Like maybe from like Korean lore or something, folk tales or something. Although I think Ahri isn't she like based on Japanese like folklore? I don't know. Maybe there's something with like the heads here that makes sense. I mean, do we have nine? Is it nine? Yeah, we have nine. So obviously nine-tailed fox, that makes sense. But yeah, I mean, I think the design is just a bit too basic. It looks good. I will buy it, but. I think it could be a bit more like T1 or Faker, right? Obviously, it's not a world skin, but it's a skin for Faker. And I mean, do we get the unkillable Demon King vibes, right? The Demon King, Trial of the Demon King, immortalized Ahri skin. I don't get any of these vibes here from this. Like, it's not, I mean, the here these foxes, they look kind of demonic, right? Demon King-ish. But yeah, overall, I think it's good. But it could be like much better. Yeah, that's my take. Okay, my friends. So now, actually, I think 3 days since I recorded the part you just saw. Yeah, they released more content, right? I nearly had the video finished. Was preparing everything, and yeah, we have three more clips. Let's get right into the first one. It's called The Numbers. Not sure what we expect, right? We already saw the plays. Now they're going to go over all his career stats. That will be the video now. I hope that we can always post when these motherfuckers are doubting Faker's greatness. Legendary debut, yes, 13th 04. Days of dedication, yeah, okay, nice one. Should I talk? most final appearances, 16, most titles in the LCK, 10, right? We're working on the 11th one. First 10, first, yeah, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, right? Kill record, obviously, right? First 500 game wins, 600, and we can continue, right? Assist record, right? Also is first place there. Longest winning streak of 24 games. 6 finals consecutively in the LCK, right? Not international. First 900 appearances, okay. Played, like, I mean, some of these are, he played a lot of League of Legends, but youngest champions, now we get the oldest champion, yes. Nice. Among all mid laners, of course, right? There's score. And I don't know, how old was Khan? Well, whatever. What else do we have? We get some, okay, world's appearances, yeah, most as well. You have to understand, by the way, he played for, okay, yeah. First consecutive world champions, most final appearances, most titles, international titles, yeah. Mm. Yeah. Do we get the banger transition? Yes. One and only 4-time world champion. Yeah. Most wins international, 181 among all players. Understandable, right? What else? High win rate, right? 71.7% win rate. Insane, by the way. Youngest world champion and oldest world champion. Hey. Good times. We get oldest. Yes. Oldest as well. Yes. Among all players. Yes, yes. Very nice. Yeah. Most matches as well. Most wins. Yes. Most kills. Most assists. I hope he doesn't have most deaths. I think he's not there. Serious win rate versus LPL at Worlds, sadly only at Worlds only, but a serious win rate at Worlds in general, 82.6%, right? Higher than the games, but a highest win rate in the world, obviously, that year where we went 15-1, I think, or something like that. Most consecutive titles, 4, I mean, yeah, went pretty well. When and only 2-time world champion without losing a single series. Yes. Most appearances, obviously referring to 14 winter, I think. All the MVPs, yes, very nice. The only player with 24 seasons on one team. And bro is loyal. Get yourself a man like Faker, man. Not only being the GOAT, but also like a loyal. Man. Look at this guy, man. I cried like a bitch watching at this. And yeah, very, very good video. Some stats went pretty fast, but nice to choosing of pictures, animations, or video material and song. Okay, and now, I mean, that was a great video. We can post that, we can show that to the haters, right? And now this is the new trailer for the skin. That was the queue, okay. Looks, is the death animation, okay. Wait, huh? We get 2 skins? Wait. 100 levels of reward. Wait a second. What? Okay. Oh, okay. In the mode. Get 3, 4, 5. A warp skin. Hide on bush. What? So 2 skins. 6 emotes. A warp skin. What? Wait, I thought we only get Ahri. Ahri collectors. Event exclusive skin. Wait, what? So there are variances of the skin, like chromas or what? 4, 18, 42. That went over my head. Is it like leveling up the skin and like it gets better? Nice charm. Okay, boom, bomba. Or is it like a legendary skin that gets better, like the more kills you get in a game or something like that? Okay, that was amazing. Okay, what do we get here? Unique animation for... Okay. My first complaint, right, just a couple minutes ago in this video, was like, hey, the skin has nothing to do with Faker, right? But now, with all these extras, they added the Faker to the skin. I mean, here the mask on the ball, right? for like the demon, right? Now this is at least something connected to Faker. Not sure what this is. This is the pose, whatever it is, right? For both skins. We get two skins. Amazing. Finally gets a Leblanc and an Ahri skin. Two skins that we waited upon. Now we finally get them with this like cool pose. Wonder how it really looks in game. Destruction of turrets gets you Faker, and I think this is the recall animation with all four trophies. And obviously the most ugly one being the one, yeah, most recent, right? And okay, iconic pose. I like this, I like this. Not sure how, where does it, like these are, like, let's check out the emotes, right, obviously. So, firstly, obviously, reference to his first kill ever. Here. The Z emote, it's okay. The Azir emote is like this, I guess. Okay. This one, the Ahri emote, kind of looks cute. Right, obviously, a reference with the multiple heads. What was that, World 16, I think? No, was that 16? Was that even World? Whatever it was, obviously it's fun. Yeah, Broccoli 2015, that's a cool one. Broccoli is just great. Eat broccoli, my friends. And not sure where this like meme comes from. But yeah, obviously looks fine. The ward, not pretty, but looks cool. What do we get here? Just showing off the Leblanc skin or whatever it is. And now, how does this work? Event exclusive skins. I mean, I'll probably can just look at some text wall posted by Riot Games somewhere, but okay, look at Ahri here. 4.18.42. If I look at the skin, it doesn't look all that different, right? All three Ahri skins look the same. So the question is like, how do you rank up the skin? Does it work if you get kills in game? Like, I don't know, with like other legendary skins, right? Or is it legendary skins or ultimate skins, right? Where you like, for example, Pulsefire Ezreal, you level up and then you like look cooler. We'll have to see. And this is dope. This is dope. So overall, I think the skin looks pretty dope. Not sure if I understand everything correctly, but they added the Faker flare that was needed. And yeah, now the last video is the skin spotlight for Faker skins, Ahri and Leblanc. Right, shout out to Skin Spotlight. They don't need me, but yeah. Wait a second. What? Signature Ahri. How much RP is that? What the fuck? Oh, my face is probably in front of it. 59,260 RP. How much money is that? What? 59,000 RP? What? For the signature feature or what? I mean, we'll leave the sig- Okay, so we're- What the hell? So these are the Faker skins, right? We have the Leblanc. It's probably the other like Hall of Legends skin, and then obviously the three World skins. Three out of the four that we already have. Where is Orianna, by the way? Still not out. Yeah. And they get like an RGB effect, okay. Looks kind of weird. I mean, Faker signature stays. Okay, what else? What else do we have here? What were we supposed to look at? Okay, yeah. Okay, cool. Okay. So... Okay, from getting kills or getting turret plates and whatever. The skin levels up. Okay, so it is like a collectible experience, right? And then... Yeah, okay, that's the recall we already saw. Again, looks pretty good. Yeah, nice. Okay. Yeah. The skin looks very different. Five. 10, okay. When does she... Is this a completely different skin? Wait. Risen? Wait a sec. We completely missed everything. Wait, so there's signature Ahri? Wait. This goes over my head like a fucking airplane. Okay, this is signature Ahri? with for like half a million euros or dollars or whatever, and this is immortalized Ahri. What the fuck? Why is it 10 skins? I want one good skin. Huh? Why is that so hard? So this is the skin that can like rank up. And then there's Risen, which is like the lighter one for 5,438 RP. And this is the one that we looked at, right? But has a different recoil animation. What the fuck are you doing there, Riot Games? You had a simple mission, make one great skin. And like, or make two with like the Leblanc. Hey, fine by me, but huh? What is this? Oh, she has special emotes herself. She also has this recoil animation. She also giving us the, yeah, okay. Risen Legend Leblanc. Okay, so we get, there's one Leblanc skin and like three Ahri skins. Okay, we'll have to look into that. What is the recoil? I don't know what this recoil. Okay, we have a lot of other skins. Let's see what this is now all about. Okay, my friends. I found four more videos. More video content. The video will go longer. Now we're taking a look at all skins. There are new chromas for like the three skins that we saw. So it's not only like some RGB effect in game. It's actually full on new skins. For like Zed, Ryze, and what's her name? Syndra. Cool. And yeah, we have also like a skin spotlight for Leblanc. We'll get onto everything, but we also have voice lines. But the like crazy news is I looked up what the, what was it, 59,000 RP is? That's 500 euros for a skin? What the fuck, Riot Games? You, what? You have lost your goddamn fucking mind. A skin honoring a player being completely unaffordable to 99% of the League of Legends population. Like, sure, I maybe have spent 500 euros on League in my lifetime on skins, which I think is absolutely crazy. Like, what the fuck? And it's not about not having the money, it's about spending 500 euros on a skin or a skin bundle. I still have not completely understood what I'm paying for, but like there is nothing in League of Legends that's worth paying 500 euros. We're talking about skins. Man, I love Faker. I mean, you all see my fucking channel. I mean, I'm an insane T1 fanboy. And it's like, I would fly to a T1 match and everything. I would spend big money on all of that. But not, I would spend over 500 money, like meeting like Faker and traveling to Korea for a match or whatever. Yes, but not 500 euros for a skin? What the fuck? And especially with like Faker. Like that guy never plays skins. Like honoring the guy that never uses skin with the most expensive skin. Is that like Riot Games revenge on Faker because he doesn't use their skins or he doesn't promote them? Like what the fuck? I mean, this is just fucking sad, man. I was so looking forward to buying this. And I mean, I will probably buy at least the cheapest one or at least like something. I'll have to take a look at it again. But what the fuck? This is just, I'm so angry and so sad. It's just pure disappointment. Hiya, man. Let's enjoy the voice lines here. I'm about to fucking lose my mind. What the fuck? You are self-aware. You are self-aware. Oh my god. There's no way. Wait till the demon. Wait, if Faker hears about the price, 500 euros for a skin, he's going to fucking, like, buy Riot Games and, like, make the skin free. What the fuck? I mean, by the way, absolutely amazing that we get voice lines for the skin of, like, Faker. This is just amazing. This is everything, like, I wanted, right? Custom voice lines, animations, putting Faker into the game like that. Something he deserves and something that we've waited for a long time. But now, over all of this glory and just this greatness, the idea of Hall of Legends, like, great, we needed that, we wanted that as, like, fans and everything. Everything about this, like, was so great. Then we saw the skin the first time, I was like, right, you saw it in this video, right? This is now, like, at least 3-4 days ago, when I recorded that. I was like, ah, okay, looks fine, but could be better, could be more Faker. Now I see this video material, I'm like, yes, finally Faker in the skin, and it's just, it doesn't even matter. This could be the best skin ever. It's never worth 500 euros. Actually, first encounter, okay. Okay, okay, so. Okay, baller, all roads lead to me. Please don't overuse it, but I mean, that's a banger line. Kill a Raisin Leblanc, okay. Raisin Legend Leblanc? Oh man, I'm not... This goes all over my head. What's with these names? Risen Legend Leblanc? Wasn't there like... Whatever, let's just listen. Okay. Imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, you know. Okay. Bit cringe, but hey, it has something. A warning for all who doubt me. With every deed, I evolve. Okay. Worlds collide. Worlds collide is the best world song. I'll exceed it. Overall, like solid quotes, right? Some of them are obviously directly like from Faker and relation to Faker. When trying to play God. Okay. Yeah. Direct song reference here. I don't get this lore, right? This is it's Trials of the Demon King, but then she says herself that she's the like Demon King. Not sure what the lore here is behind what they're setting up, right? Leblanc seems to be like the keeper or something. Because maybe that's like Faker's first like legendary skin and or rather champion that he was like ballin', right? I mean, that's like to be fair, right? His Leblanc was the first one that like sent waves in Korea. Obviously with that, he became like international sensation. Okay, again, fine. Cook, again, she's talking to the Demon King. Obviously makes sense, right? She's not Faker, it's Ahri. But again, it's at some points, it's like she's him. I don't know. Oh my god, this reminds me of a picture I will pull up. Yeah, that kind of reminds me of this, like fan art, absolutely gorgeous. Not sure who draw it, whatever, it's an older one. But yeah, I mean, here we have, yeah, obviously Faker, 17, sorry. Zed and his other champions, like, what is it, comforting him, so yeah. Maybe that's a reference to like something like that. Probably not, but yeah. Watching all that I've become, they deserve to witness. Is this a reference to like Faker and his family, right? His father and his grandmother watching him, but okay. I don't know what all these like things referencing to. Maybe we're getting like some like new lore that I don't know anything about. But yeah, obviously the shards being referenced here a lot. Again, now she's talking to Faker, but with if she's like doing the pentakill, that's correct. Transformation here again, collecting the shards and then transforming. So my guess on that skin part was correct. What is the shard lore with like Faker? But whatever. Pretty standard things, right? Like, I mean, they sound cool, right? It's not like, I don't know, Ooga Booga, Zak Zak. But, yeah. Whoa, that bell. Damn. That bell. Whoa, that sounds great. You will never hear it in game, probably, because it's like being overtuned by other sounds, but. Hey, nice. Oh, you're also never going to hear it in-game because no one is going to pay for 500 euro skin. Never mind. That's why we have to watch the entire 10 minutes of like voice lines here, because you will never hear these voice lines in-game because no one will play this, like half the skin, besides like fucking streamers or something who like make money as they breathe. But yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, thinking about this, right, looking again at the quotes, right, we have Faker as a demon and as a god at the same time, right? If we look at basically the color scheme, we also have the like the light and the dark, right? right? So, I mean, actually, this just further underlines, like, Faker as a special one, as the GOAT, right? He's not the villain, right? He's the villain for his opposition, right? For his challengers. But in truth, he's just a really nice, kind guy. So, like, he's, like, the positive force, God, but he's also the Demon King for his challengers, right? So, right? Hiya, wrong. But yeah. Yeah, maybe that's what they went for with this. I don't know. Not sure what they had in mind besides fat money. Anyway, so yeah, voice lines overall, I think good. I think maybe it's a bit too much. 10 minutes of voice lines. Yeah, a bit iffy, right? We have no like lore that is being explored. Like maybe they invent some lore for this. I don't know. Maybe the lore is real life. The lore is Faker, right? Yeah, again, nice references to like Faker quotes. Situations, songs, anything, right? Nice. Some of these have to be like a bit more like tune in, right? It's like, oh, the god, and it's like, I don't know. It's all right. Overall, it's a, like positive, right? Is it 10 out of 10? No, but how, like, what would a 10 out of 10 voice line look like besides maybe Kindred or something? Anyway, let's move to the next one. What do we have here as next in our playlist? Risen Leblanc, right? Risen Legend Leblanc, right? Is there a difference between Leblanc and Risen Leblanc? I don't know. I only know that's lagging right now. Give me a moment. Not too bad, not too bad. Again, we see the shards, right? We don't know the lore aspect for that. It seems like there's a seal on Faker or on the Demon King, and oh, okay, that's a pretty skin. Does it look like Leblanc though? Wait, give me a moment. Let's go back. Does this look like Leblanc? Right, if we, I don't know, only zoom in on the face or something. It is a bit same face, right? Like the new like issue with League of Legends for some, and arguable for a lot of skins, that like we have same face system here. We see the marks, right? This is a bit more Leblanc-ish, could also be like, doesn't Diana also have like these marks under her eyes? Yeah, it's a bit iffy. But I think overall the aesthetic's pretty nice. Again, we have the like light, dark, and going on for like Demon King and God, right? The positive and the negative maybe that you want to combine here. Yeah, overall very clean model, right? You see like it's, I don't know, 4K or something. So you pay for some quality, you have to say. Here the Q mark. Why was it in a different color? Okay, W looks fine. Yeah, overall positive. Yeah, nice animations, nice particles going on. Yeah, can't say anything bad. Okay, yeah, Shane also looks good. Again, maybe Leblanc in this like lore that we have going on is like more focused like on the negative, right? It's like all pretty red, red, so like more focused on the Demon King aspect. I don't know, man. I'm just like trying to say some nonsense while we see like Leblanc Q animations, right? Different, what is it? Q? Mark? If it's Q or RQ. It's the crit animation here. Looks fine. It's not going to be something you see. Passive. Nothing too special. The clone looks fine. Clone looks pretty nice, actually. Pretty distinct. And different, right? We get next, death animation. Okay, that was pretty lackluster. Oh, chromas, okay. Promo recall. Again, I don't know what this like three marks have to do with anything. Like it's not even a reference to like the world titles or championship titles. But wait, what is this? This all goes over my head. But yeah, it's just a chroma, right? The animations all are the same? Or was there some green right now? Was there some green now on the W? I mean, the E looks basically the same. Okay, oh, this looks pretty nice. Paragon chroma recolored FVX. I don't know, man. Looks good so far. Looks better than the green one. Do we get different... Oh, and we get different colors. Okay, we have a red one and a blue one. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Okay, maybe this is the, like, good, like, Demon King and, like, God, good guy Faker. I don't know. again, probably looking into something that is not even there, giving Riot Games some credit with like the things they say. But yeah, so I think it's probably the most expensive one, but I think the blue one is pretty nice. But overall, looks like a high quality skin. Nothing really bad to say. Again, where's the faker aspect in this? But it's like the mini skin, right? It's just the Happy Meal, right? You go to McDonald's, you order food, you get like your burger, your chicken nuggets or whatever. Don't go to McDonald's, don't eat fast food. It's bad for you, don't do it. But in case you do, I assume you go there to buy food. And this skin is like the fries, right? You get it to your main skin, the Ahri, right? The thing that you want. And this is like the Happy Meal that you get to the side. Always pretty nice, right? You want it, you enjoy it. I mean, it's a really nice skin, but again, where's the faker part? It looks like a Conqueror. It looks like a really good Conqueror skin. Probably only going to be worth like 250 euros or something. I don't know. Yeah, and again, the green one looks a bit... Where's the green one? The green one looks pretty weird, right? They also didn't change the... What is it? The animations, the particles or anything. They could have just made them green. Just the same thing in green would be better. Would still look a bit off, but hey, whatever. Next skin, let's go to the next one. The Leblanc skin, really nice. And the Paragon part, right? The last one in blue was an interesting part. Now let's see Paragon Chroma SKTZ. Hopefully, man, I've been waiting for this for a long time. The old world skins, like not only for T1 or like SKT, but for many teams, they suck. Obviously, they're 10 years plus old. Please give them a revamp, right? If you could, I don't know, if you made the TPA Orianna skin better, maybe, can we name that guy? Maybe, oh, I can't pronounce the name. Troyce? Maybe that guy wouldn't have committed all his crimes and wouldn't have ended the way he did, because he would have gotten more money from his skin. Yeah, obviously that, you know how I talk, right? You know that this is hyperbole. Okay, I don't know, It looks quite a bit off. I don't like this coloring. It's RGB, but washed out RGB. It just looks weird. The champion looks good, right? Higher quality like blades and icons, right? Looks good, but I don't like the fact that his color is like, yeah, I don't know. It looks like washed out RGB from like a cheap store. I don't know. If you like this, right? If you're like a... like 2010-ish... I don't know, gamer, right? Who have like RGB all over your desktop or something. I don't know, maybe that's your thing. I think if they just made this in like red or like red-black, this would have been really nice. But yeah, I think this is a miss. The model update is nice, but yeah, it sucks. Okay, yeah, it's going to be the same with Rise. Here they didn't... Oh, it lags. They didn't upgrade, I think, the main model. It looks very similar. Maybe made it like a higher resolution or something. I don't know. Looks a bit iffy on the legs. But yeah, again, it looks weird. It looks weird. I'm not a fan of. I don't understand why they did that with the Leblanc skin, right? The Paragon version was clean blue, gold, white. Very nice color scheme, working well with each other, complementing and so on and so on. This one, I mean, they even made the abilities RGB, or like not even RGB, it's like a purplish, blue, purple, green. It just looks very, I don't know, you have to like it, I think. If you like it, you will probably like it. But yeah, I don't know. Not too sure about this one here, my friends. Okay, actually, before we skip, let's wait for the old. Okay, this actually doesn't look too bad. But again, I don't know. Let's continue with the next skin, I say. Okay, obviously, this skin, right? I think it was the first one that introduced like the signatures, right, for the world skins. And let's see the RGB here. What is it? Yeah, skin spotlight's very nice. Okay, so it's the dress. It's not the skin color that's changing, right? Yeah, but the Cinder herself also look at her arms. She looks like a ghost or something. Just looks very weird. I think the color of the balls is fine, but yeah. Here it's not as extreme, like the RGB effect, but it's just, yeah, the colors are just not pleasant, right? The idea, maybe it could work. I don't know. I don't think so, but maybe it could work. But I think the colors just, it's just, I don't know. It's very, like, good to see. It's not pleasant to see, but it's like a nice skin, right? It's not making, it's not hiding her itself with the background or something, right? If you're struggling with sight, this is going to be easy to see, right? These balls, they're not invisible or something. We'll have to see how they look in River, actually, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Not a big fan of the Paragon skins, as I assumed, besides the Leblanc one. But yeah, that's about it. Do we have more videos? If not, we'll see. Okay, now I'd say let's take a look at the Hall of Legends like website. Maybe there's some new info. I don't know if like this video is probably not too much new stuff for all of you. It's just everything like at this point, right? 30th of May. Everything that we know about all of this, right? First among legends, right? It's like here a bit of honoring Faker, collections with a new take. Wait, collaborate Faker this year. So is it going to be Hall of Legends year by year? Okay, let's see. We collaborated with Faker. Okay. Did Faker have a say in this? Well, hopefully, at least to some extent. To offer something for everyone. Okay. Didn't know everyone was rich like that. Maybe I'm just the outlier. I mean, again, I have the money, but I'd rather spend 500 euros on, I don't know, all kinds of different things. Like, I don't know, at least, like, even Yu-Gi-Oh cards. I have done that, but it's like, a skin in a video game. Like, I don't know, man. Especially, like, I don't even play Ahri, right? I mean, it's like, what? Whatever, let's continue reading. So, the trailer, we've watched that. That's the splash art for... Wait, okay, so now we're getting into the product. This is something I saw, but I wanted to take a look at it myself. So, relive Faker's career highlights through 100 levels of unlockable rewards, including commemorative skins and a special callback. Wait, so you have to earn all of that? Oh god, that sounds even terrible. So I have to play the game? Oh god, no, do not force me to play League of Legends, man. So pass rewards, the skin... The SKTZ, oh, actually, so the you get the skins as well for 19. Okay, that's actually good price. Mythic Ascents, 125. Okay, I'll get this one, 100%. 14 Faker, Ific, coins and emotes. We see all of them and more. Okay, I guess and more. 6 orbs, a banner, hide on bush ward, and Broccoli Baron title. We have something here in this video that will help us. Or is this just something that we saw already? This looks pretty similar to what we saw already. Is this just the skin? Yeah, okay, I think it's just the skin that we already saw. Yeah, I think this is good value, right? 3 skins if you don't have them. Why do you not have them? 3 skins plus a new skin and all kinds of little nice things. I think this is like, what, 10 euros, 15 euros or something? I don't like buy RP as much anymore. So I don't have the like exact values in my head anymore. So okay, like even if we say it's 20 euros, I think this is still fine, I think. Like icons, mythic essence, 4 skins, and all kinds of unique Faker contents, right? And more. So yeah, so first thing is already good, but now let's get to this shit here. Let's start with the... So we have Risen, Immortalized, and Signature. So this is the Risen one for 4,430 RP. So this is more than 3 times... What was it? 19, right? So let's say 20 or 2,000. So this is like... So yeah, let's say 50 euros, right? For 5,000. Yeah, that's probably all right. Hall of Legends pass... So you get the other one included. Okay, that's at least something, right? That's 2,000 subtracted. So the rest only costs 3,400, right? Roughly. You get the Ahri skin, takedown counter is this inherent for all, like, for all time, or is this like part of the Ahri skin? You get Ahri as a champion, okay. Does it mean it's going to be cheaper if I already have Ahri as a champion? We'll have to see. I mean, here, like, the artwork, pretty charming, right? Pretty nice. Again, where are the Faker aspects? We have, like, a crown, that's pretty cool. But nothing else that screams Faker. Actually, the tail looks better. No fucking, like, dogs. I again, don't get the reference. Please let me know in the comments down below what the, like, dogs, or rather the foxes, probably, have to do with Faker. I don't know why they added. And we got border, exclusive icon, and emote, so for Ahri, right? I think that's the one we already saw. Do we see it in this little animation here? Yeah, you get the kill. Yeah, nice, nice, nice. Do we get the little emote here? This is the def, the kill counter. And the emote? No emote. I mean, we saw the emote already. It was like a heart, right, or something like that. I think this is... okay, I think this is pricey, but 50 euros? For like a like ultra special skin with all kinds of add-ons, and HOL Hall of Legends pass. I think this is good value. I think that's all right. It's a bit pricey, but I mean, we're talking about like skins anyway. They're always going to be a bit pricey for just being like fancy graphics, right? But this is all right. Now, this is not all right anymore. This is a 6x price increase. So we're, if this is 50, if this is roughly 50 euros or dollars, I don't know, then this is at least 6, right? It's like even more, right? It's 6.5, so we're at least like 300-ish, maybe I was wrong, right? At least we're like, let's say 250 to 300-ish euros or dollars or whatever. That's insane. Like this could be like everything, like meet and greet with Faker, free food for a year, like anything could stand here, and it would not be, it would not warrant such a price. This is insane. And like, sure, luxury skins and so on, it's cool. And like, a skin doesn't have to, like, you can make skins that are like for like the bourgeois people, absolutely fine if you want to introduce something like that. It has to be obviously a bit discreet, right? So it's not pay to win, but like, there could be a place for that. But this is definitely not the place. Honoring the GOAT of League of Legends and introducing Hall of Legends and all of that by doing this is disgusting. Obviously, doing such a great, like a complete, like such a baller skin that we're going to read through is going to take a lot of money and effort, right? The Riot Games employees and the AI they used and whatever, I don't even know, right? Whatever they did, right? It was hard work to do the skin. And that needs to be rewarded, right? But honestly, they could charge 5 euros for the skin. Everyone in League of Legends, right? Everyone that plays League of Legends or is like a League of Legends fan would buy the skin. Like, you get 1 billion sales for 5 euros and you would make the same money. They're going to lose money by charging so much for that. That's something that you have to understand, right? There's going to be still millions of people buying this. But a tenth at most of what you could, like a number of sales that you could have gotten otherwise. Like, I'm not paying 200. It pains my heart. I was so down to buy the skin and all the Faker merch. I've paid more money than this for SKT and T1 jerseys over the last 3 years. I have 3 jerseys and a jacket, right? All of that costed me more money than that, but I have something feasible. It's not a skin, it's a jersey. The money directly went to T1. From a business standpoint, it's fucking insane. From a like perspective, like honoring Faker and that correlation to that, it's very disrespectful putting like doing something as this, like with his name next to that. This is just disgusting. But okay, now let's take a look at what we get. So we get the skin, exclusive structure finisher, right, with the signature. That looks really cool. The champ finisher looks very cool. Not as cool as the structure one, but also cool. Custom visual announcer. Custom visual announcer. Not sure what this means, but I see announcer. Announcer sounds cool. Unique skin transformations. 3 Demon King forms with unique VO. I mean, the skin looks great, right? It's a high quality skin. You can't say like shit, right? Also, the splashed out with an animation, right? In contrast to the stock image here. Not stock image, still image. By the way, none of these look like the Ahri that we saw in the trailer, I think. They look pretty different. Which is good, by the way. And again, I don't know what these wolves or foxes have to do with this. The rose is pretty nice, in case you don't know. Not sure if it's still the fact, but Faker's like League of Legends icon has always been the red rose icon, the base icon. He has not changed that, I'd like to say, but at least that was the case for many years. Demon Chosen transformation with Demon King HUD or HUD during ult, right? I've not seen that one. I'm not sure if this is in this trailer here. Can we? Okay, we can't. But whatever. Would have loved to see that, but okay. But yeah, I've heard about this. This sounds really cool, right? You get a unique HUD for your abilities during ult. Pretty nice. Risen Legend collection. So you get all of this. Or all of this. Oh yeah, so you get the Risen skin as well, you get all of this stuff as well, and this also obviously includes this one, which, I mean, at least it does that. It would be worse if you had to go at everything. Dynamic profile background. Okay, that sounds pretty cool. Immortalized border and exclusive icon and emotes. Again, all of this is amazing. This is great, gorgeous even. But not for like over 200 euros, maybe even 300 euros or dollars, whatever. This is the biggest issue. If this was for 50 euros, that would be great. If this was for up to 100 euros for all of this, that would be tough. And would, again, I think it would even harm the business. But I just, let's go to the next one. Okay, so what is the difference here? Signature Ahri skin upgrades. Faker signature move as a Faker's structure finisher. So you get the structure finisher, and then you obviously get this like Faker silence, right, with the finger on the mouth that we saw in a previous part of the video. Final boss Faker title. Oh god, man, that sounds pretty fucking pretty ballers. Signature immortalized, signature banner, everything with Faker signature. I mean, I want this signature splash out for Ahri and Leblanc. Immortalized legendary collection, so you get this, you get the Risen. The ugly chromas are in this! You can't even get the ugly chromas if you wanted to, unless you pay 500 euros! I mean, that's at least good, I don't have to look at these ugly shit chromas. Oh my god, you get even more exclusive icons and emotes, nice. So you get all the Risen, where is it? You get the Immortalized Legend Collection, which obviously includes the Risen one, and it includes the Hall of Legends. Okay, this is at least something, right? So with the ultimate 500 million euros skin, you get all the other like skins and versions and upgrades. Sounds amazing. This should be at maximum. A skin should not be over 100 euros, right? A skin for 100 euros? I mean, there are gacha games in Japanese and Korean culture where skins go up to like 200, 300 euros. So in their culture or in like their gaming sphere, maybe it's a bit more understandable, but gacha games as a culture and as like a spending habit are also very different from mobile League of Legends, right? And obviously we as a Western audience are a bit different, but Riot Games in theory is still like also a Western like company. Sure, the biggest market are the Chinese, right? But I mean they are like some people in that country obviously wealthy, but I don't know, man, if like the I don't know billion League of Legends players from China are willing to spend the 500 euros or 500 euro value on this one. That's the prices are just, it's so sad. This was like, this was a moment we as T1 fans especially, I think, waited for, like a Faker skin, not only a world skin but a skin for Faker. And obviously Faker Ahri, right? We were in shambles when he said that he's not going to take Ahri as his world skin, right? Probably because he was talking with Riot Games about like this already at the time, right? That's highly likely. I would assume that they are in works. They have been in works with that. Probably a reason why the world skins are delayed is because of this. I would assume, but right, we didn't get an SKT Ahri skin. For this, we didn't get an SKT Leblanc skin. Obviously, he didn't play Leblanc at Worlds, but we didn't get all of that for this event here. And this event, if you look at everything here without the prices, it's amazing. Frequently asked questions. What is Hall of Legends? Shut the fuck up, we know. When will Hall of Legends event and... Wait, again, it's an event. Oh, it's so cringe. Just give me the product. June to July. Okay, so during like what is it, summer split, will Hall of Legends be returned annually? Yes, every year a pro player from the history of League of Legends esports will be honored and introduced into Hall of Legends. This does not answer the question. Does that mean next year we can still get the Faker skin, or is it like you get every skin every year? That would also be terrible. Is there a revenue share? Oh, that's pretty important. Yes, 24 inductee and some esports, some League esports tournament went in 30% gross revenue from the Hall of Legends event. So Faker, right? Let's just say Faker and some LOL esports teams. What, some? It's T1, and like, I mean, obviously this probably is like future proof, right? So like for Uzi, probably like all the teams he played on will get a share for whatever reason. I don't know why. I mean, actually, why do the teams get a cut? Huh? Why would the teams get a cut? This is only for the player. This is not a world skin which is related to the team. That makes no sense. Where are the collection pricing options and offerings decided? Okay. Whenever you are a new fan, long time diehard, or just want to join the celebration, we thought it is essential for there to be something for you and for everyone as we celebrate. Yes, for most casual fans, we have some of our most generous bundles today. Fair. Actually, the Hall of Legends bundle is a very high value, right? Four skins, all kinds of things. Correct. The Hall of Legends pass includes multiple skins, emotes and more. Comma. While the Risen Legend Collections adds the new Risen Legend Ahri skin for collectors to enjoy. You are... For those looking to flex their fandom, the Immortalized Legend Collection and Signature blah, 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 include spectacular additions heading into the evolving... Like, while more expensive, these versions are meant to be highly commemorative... fucking English words... at 3 a.m. with never before implemented features that we can't wait to see. You will never see it because no one pays 500, and obviously not no one. Again, our streamers with thousands of millions of euros will probably pay it, or they won't because they want to appear cool and close to their audience. Who will pay? I mean, oh man, I hope I'm not going to be such a fucking moron. I am the idiot that's going to do that in the end. I know myself. Oh my god, I hope I will not do it in the future. This cannot be supported. I mean, I am just waiting to see, like, I've been like, going a bit back, right? Taking a bit of a like break from like the League of Legends scene. Obviously, there's no content right now. Roster rumors and all that nonsense. Like, okay, we'll take a look at it at some point maybe. So I've been taking a bit of a step back. So obviously, I can also like blind react to all of this. The community will be obviously furious, I have to hope. Like, there's no way. Oh, will I ever be able to this? You will be unable to acquire everything for the foreseeable future. At current, this content is meant to be of only for a limited time only, and there's no. Jesus Christ, man, they don't want to bring it back. So, all like, if you don't have 500 euros lying around right now, sorry, fuck you. You will never be able to spend this money again. This is also stupid. like limited time stuff. I mean, like there are some reasons some people like it. I just never liked it. Obviously, it's fine if it's like available every year or something like that, but just never. It's disgusting. Yeah, I mean, again, the way they try to explain why this skin with all these great features, don't get me wrong. Oh, never mind. All these great features besides the fucking Paragon chromas. Like, I'm not going to say that shit is great. All of this is amazing. The whole pass is amazing, but it's just disgusting. I can't believe this. They actually did this. I can't believe they put a fucking 500 euro skin in the game. It's like I'm recording now for like hours. It feels like for this like set with so much anticipation, with so much hope, with such a goodwill coming into this. Disappointed by the first look of the skin, then like being hopeful again by looking at voice lines. And by like animations and all of this, like seeing improvement, seeing like the unique features, but then we get to the price and it's all ruined because it's not accessible for me and for, I bet, for a vast majority of the people watching and obviously out there. This is just horrible. It's so horrible. And oh, this skin is only 50 euros. Even this skin is fucking shit expensive and it's a tenth of the it's a okay, and I'm not saying anything new. I will put a cut to this and yeah, maybe we actually will take a peek at the community reactions to this. Give me a moment. Okay, my friends, we've ventured into the deep ends. We've taken a look at Reddit. Probably should have looked at Twitter, but yeah, I cannot guarantee that it's all going to be yeah, friendly. Reddit at least is moderated by the Stasi, by the secret police, FBI, whatever you want to call it. So there's no way we're going to see too much, like all too crazy stuff here. But yeah, 6 years ago, I thought someday I would come up in your shop. I was waiting for it to buy out on sale. Yeah, Faker himself is not, like he didn't even buy all of his own skins, right? Right, they have not given Faker and the others like their skins for free. Yeah, so this is just something else, right? Okay, taking a look here at the highest upvoted post I found, and obviously it's about this. 15,000 upvotes, looking at my viewers. yeah, this is a lot. The Hall of Legends event was never about celebrating Faker, it was to use him to make money. They will not beat these allegations with prices like that. Almost every League player loves Faker. I mean, yeah, there are these motherfuckers in my comment sections and on what is the League Unlock? If you ever go in the comment section of League Unlock videos, you better like have your anti-radiation and anti-toxicity suit on. Jesus Christ, these people are wild. But yeah, like everyone loves Faker besides mentally ill people, and we would love to own the Ahri skin dedicated to him. Riot putting the skin be a $600? It's getting more expensive. Inflation, man. It's crazy. $600 paywall is the biggest insult imaginable to us. Yes. On point. Riot choose to exploit or allow for Faker for their own... Yeah. I mean, there's no better way to phrase this. This is just hitting the nail on the head. Yeah. They exploit our love for Faker. And again, it's not about the skin not being like worth money. Or a lot of money. Again, like... I'd say for it all, 100 euros, or even for like the super premium thing, you could go with 150. I think that is a lot of money. It, like imagine how much like you, your parents, like have to work for 150 euros, right? Or dollars, right? And like, sure, yeah, super rich people, shut the fuck up, happy for you. Maybe donate money if you have so much money left over, whatever, right? Even 150 euros for like the total skin ultra omega thing would have been a lot of money. It would be three times the amount for a normal legendary skin or ultra omega skin, whatever they're called, ultimate skin, whatever, right? That would have been a lot of money, and I think they would have made a lot of money by that. Again, the argument, the higher the price point is, the less people will buy it. The cheaper it is, the more people will buy it. Because demand is not a problem for this product called Faker's Hall of Legends skin. The demand is through the roof. The only thing stopping people from buying your product is in way too high price point. And again, Riot Games, if they're like not completely retarded, they should have been able to like figure this stuff out by themselves. Anyway, next paragraph. We have not even started, right? I'm just again rambling the same words of disbelief and anger, disappointment. Yeah, whatever. This was supposed. Okay, English is not all first language. This was supposed to be something to remember Faker by when he retired, when he has retired, and prove that we were there. Here and cheering for him when he was still playing and lifted those trophies. Faker never uses skins, probably because he wanted to show the world that you don't need to be rich to be good at the game and be someone great. Maybe, probably. Faker's like origin is decently humble, right? There are like not wanting to say like half truths, but I mean there are like some stories that like he had to get food stamps and like shit as a kid, right? Like that guy comes from I don't know, like a self-made millionaire in the book. Obviously, people like reached out to him, helped him in his life, from family members to like people at T1 and Coma and everyone, right? But it's still his own hard work that led him into his position. And again, to use someone who claimed from nothing to something, as far as I know, for like, again, for this, it's just crazy. Funny thing is, if the bundles were priced at $100, then at least six times more players would have been able to afford it and brought it, right, would have made more. Yeah, this is the same argument I am making. But the greed at Riot is too short-sighted to see that they do not get a FOMO, whatever this means. The skin will not be a memento of flaw for Faker, but a proof of your idiocy and greed and just whatever. The most expensive skin in celebration of the player who never used one. I mean, there are some times, and they're probably now talking about the skins. Can you close this? Yes. I already have Faker's Ahri skin. It's called the base skin, and in honor of Faker, that's the skin I'll be using. Yeah, I already, what is it? I already saw that one on Twitter already. I scrolled by because, again, I didn't want to spoil myself for, like, the reaction video part here. And, yeah, again, talking about the Stasi and, secret... communist police on Reddit. My bank would flag this transaction as potential fraudulent. Yes, your bank would be correct. The worst part is, as someone who loves Ahri and has massive respect on how much of an example Faker is to the player base, I was overjoyed when he chose for his T1 skid, but then swapped to Orianna. We already got that one. But now we easily get one of the worst deals in gaming. Hiding behind the face of a beloved player. Where the hell are they thinking? Most people won't buy this in my country. The cheapest bundle, assuming that Brazil will allow bundles through, that's also a like country thing, is the price of the minimum wage or more. It makes me deeply disappointed. I'd just rather have a T1 Ahri. Yeah. I mean, like, we in like Europe and the US, right? Not everyone in these countries, right? Or countries, continents. like, at least we... Not all, but at least some of us don't sleep in tents and at least like can, I don't know, like buy a PC and play and like have the luxury to all of this, right? For us, 500 euros is a lot, but like we could afford it if we wanted to. Not everyone, but again, like at least some. But for many, many millions of T1 Faker fans, League players all around the world, like in like second world, third world countries, right? This is an insane amount of money. Like he says here, it's a minimum wage, right, for a month, I assume. And yeah, I mean, again, minimum wage obviously is maybe not the standard for everything, but what is League's player base? League's player base? What is the like the average age of like League's player base? Is it, what is it? Is it 30-year-old CEOs or something, or is it, I don't know, 15 to 25-year-old like gamers that are students like at school or at university or like in their like first years in their job, right? This is like, I think, the average player base of League of Legends, I assume. Like, how do they assume that their like average customer base, right, has the money to spend for this? And then again, we look at the different player bases, right? Europe and North America, like the richer parts, I guess, are not even the biggest player base, right? Then you look at Korea and China, right, where the biggest player bases are. But I mean, they're also well off, but yeah, with a bit more fluctuation, I guess. But then again, we're looking at continents where like no one can could afford these skins unless you are like, I don't know, an oil sheikh or something. It's just disgusting. I was expecting my boy Deft to have some Ezreal skins next year, but those no. I mean, Deft is not. I mean, hey, Deft is like a. Oh my god! Let's not talk about Deft as a like goat or whatever. Just ban every single game out of spite. You might as well spend 500 bucks into T1 merch. Yes, just do that. I mean, I probably already did that, especially with shipping costs, right? Of course, Riot isn't going to give a fuck about Faker or the players. They only care about money. Faker's not getting 50% of the profits. And the next post that I found, probably, this is a bit more recent, right? 10,000 or 11,000 upvotes, maybe some other funny reactions here. For that kind of money, I almost expect Faker himself to deliver me a code to the bundle. I would expect him to come home and play the next 10 matches for me and go on a date together. He's gonna play your placement matches. The way I thought it was 59k RP was a typo. Yeah, I mean, the first time I looked at this, I was so shocked I couldn't even read the number. It was 500 euros. Faker doesn't even use skins anyway. Every default skin is a Faker skin. Yes. Time to learn Viego. Or play Nico. Absolutely based. Nico and Viego. Yeah, let's play that shit if we see an Ahri on the enemy team. Let's celebrate the face of our esports who famously doesn't even spend money on our skins by absolutely overcharging the fuck out of his event skin. Again, not sure if I mentioned this, but it feels like a revenge move by Riot Games. Like, oh, Faker, you're not promoting our skins. We're going to take your name and drag it through the skin dirt. It's just disgusting. It's crazy that Faker, known for his generosity and taking less salary over the years so he could stay in Korea, right? The first part I already mentioned, right? He's donating like shit tons of money to like all kinds of things from like I know for a fact that he donates for like animal shelters and stuff like that. At least that's like what comes to mind first. Right? And then taking less salary over the years so he could stay in Korea and with T1. Obviously, I mean, he's still earning good amounts of money, right? It's going to be associated with these crazy packages where the base skin isn't able to transform. I looked at the two whale packages, pretty much expected like a physical Ahri statue to be included. But nope, it's just a signature. It's just, yeah, it's absolutely fucking crazy. And oh yeah, the jump between the skins is also crazy. 45 euros, I was like already like speculating. 45 euros or like 50, 45, right? To 300 and then to 500, 600, depending on probably currency. The idea of digital luxury as a goods is funny to me. That you don't even own, right? Game should shut down tomorrow and your money is gone. Yeah. And again, here, next one. Riot can ban you for a dumb reason if you're not famous enough, right? There's no way you can do anything about this. Obviously, like, don't have all chat on, but even that doesn't help you anyway nowadays. that's like 1 month's salary, right? 3 months in mine, again. Second, third world people, I mean, I'm sorry, they already have it tough and now, like, this is just an insult to your face. Cool idea, Hall of Legends, ruined by greed. Now instead of appreciating the skins, I'll be just laughing at those willing to spend $5.50. Again, the price seemed to fluctuate, again, probably due to currency. I feel bad for Faker, who's no affiliate, yep. 1 month of rent, nah, bruh. You can fly from London to New York from this, yeah, probably. What's the point of this if most players aren't going to buy it? The base skin is expensive, yes. Well, we're not getting anything new. I've Reddit people, I expected like some funny witty comments or memes or anything. Maybe we'll have to take a look at it at some other point, but yeah, again, people agree with me, you probably also agree with me. If you don't agree with me, send me the money, I'll buy the skin. I just really hope I will not at like some 3, 5, 6 o'clock, like AM, right? Middle of the night, I'm like sitting here like, what do I do? Let's play some League of Legends. I see the skin and then I'm like in my fucking mindless state. I will buy it. I already know that shit like that's going to happen. But 500 euros for a skin. Okay, let's calm down. Okay, it seems that this is the end for this journey. Hopefully, like at some point, we will get another part where it's like Riot Games apologizes, reduces the price by 100% or something. Actually, 100% is not even enough. Whatever. But yeah, I hope that's the next part of this. But yeah, that probably will be recorded at a later date. Anyway, I hope you had fun with this very long reaction video, right? We started like 3 days, 4 days ago with recordings, and now obviously a couple times later you probably saw the mixed reactions throughout the video, right? My journey experiencing this fraudulent behavior by Riot Games. I'm out of it. Anyway, hope you enjoyed, and yeah, more League of Legends content obviously coming in the future. If you like this very different type of video, yeah, hey, maybe let me know what other like reaction type of content you want to see, what other discussion type of content you want to see, and yeah, obviously let's discuss this issue in the comments down below as well, and see you next time, my friends. Bye bye.